In this video, we will talk about the basic and modified graphs. We will be using Origin to create a simple graph, meaning with a binary data column, means like two columns. Then how to plot multi-column data file, and then a very complex plot, for example, of a UV viz. We will also discuss the makeup to a graph, whether it's a line graph or it is a scatter graph or line scatter graph. So let's start with the two column data. This two column data is just like this, that we are having in one column the wavelength, for example, and in the other column the intensity. So we will be plotting this one. Let's start with the origin. And we will do the easiest procedure. Two column data I am dragging to my worksheet. Another plot is like this. Let me increase the size of the window so that it is very clearly visible. Okay, now we are having, this is the x-axis and this is the y-axis. So they are already the x and the y-axis. The very first thing that I will have to do is to write here wavelength, and then the units of wavelength will be nanometer, for example. It means these are to be written without any brackets here. And here, let's say I write intensity. This is the long name that I am using, and the unit of this, let's say, for example, I say that these are arbitrary units. Now when I will plot, I will discuss the comment as well. The f of x equals this means that some function can be done over here, so we will discuss this thing later. Spark lines in this are actually the plot which this one is having, so they are, you can say, linearly increasing points. And here, this is just a preview that how these looks like. They are just somehow like a Gaussian distribution. So let's plot this one. First, select the columns from here, and then we can plot is a line plot. So line plot is actually from here. Now inside this line, we are having horizontal steps, vertical step, and spline connected. Normally we use it from here. Another way to do this thing is plot and then come to line, and then if I click this line, it will have a line plot. Inside this one, we are having those options here as well. So it's better to go from the default from here, and it's a line plot. Now it has been plotted. Now the Origin 2018 is having some issue with the legend, and the legend is that intensity means the long name it has plotted here, and then another two are here as well. So I will double click this legend and I will remove this one. I will discuss the legend how this can be edited, but for the moment I have removed that one, and this is intensity. Now this intensity is on this axis. This may be the intensity of some concentration or whatever specification we have. So here I will write, let's say this one is 0.1 mole percent concentration, for example. And as I click here, you see that it has been updated to this one. So now we are having the plot, which is a very simple plot, and I can now do the makeup for it. If I look here, then this is the 360 point here, and this is the 400 point. So the x-axis, I can remove this portion from here, and it starts from here and it ends up here. So I will have to change the x-axis of this one. As I click this scale, it is selected. So I will have to double click this one. And here, the very first option is the scale. So the scale appears, and the very first one I am having, it is starting from this. So first I will do like this one, and let me move it here so that both the things are visible to us, and then double click here. So the menu appears here. Now the menu is required because unless and until we finalize all the graph, we are not supposed to close this one, because it's just a waste of time to do one thing and then close this one. So the first thing, I will come to the scale, and the scale is from 2. So I say from 360, and 2 is up to 400, and I do apply this one. As I applied, now my scale has reached here. Similarly, the vertical axis is starting from minus 10. If I want to just start from here, from 0, and then over here the 80 is fine. We can make it up to 75, but it is always better to leave some space here. So let me click here, and the vertical is now selected, and it is from 0 to 80, and I apply. So now our plot is like this, and it is now a decent one. If I want to change, for example, these grid lines, I click on the horizontal, and then I will go to the first one. Let's say I want to change that 360 is here. Here is the value as well. So I will change here that the increment here is not 10, means 360 and 70, it is, let's say, 5. So over there it will appear, and I just say apply. So now the values are here. If I want to change these lines, for example, the tick levels, and I click over here, and this is the tick level. Now inside the tick level, there are different options. For example, this is the decimal, this is 10^3, this is the 1k, and this we can select from here. Normally we leave it on decimal, and we are not dividing by anything. So from here we can access these axes as well. Normally we are over here on the x-axis. If I want that these lines and ticks should be upward, so I go to the line and ticks, and here I select the major ticks and the minor ticks. So if the major ticks are out, I say that they are to be n, while the minor ticks, they are n as well, and I apply, and now they are inside. Similarly, I can change these one as well. So in order to change them, I will click on this axis, the red one here, and now these can be n as well, and I do apply. Now if for example I don't want that this line, which is this one, and this line, if they are not supposed to be here, then I will have to go to grids, and here I will select the opposite lines should not be there. So this is for the horizontal opposite line, means it will be this line which will disappear. I apply and it goes away. So the horizontal line, this line disappeared. In the vertical, now this line will disappear, and I click here and I apply. So they are no more here. If I want them back, then I will have to click back the opposite under grids and I apply. This one is somehow required, because with this we can very easily decide where to place our legend. Now our plot is complete. We came to lot of makeup for this one. Let's say the tech levels. Inside the tech levels, we are having the option that if I want to use the same option for the left and right. Now this one is left and this one is right. If I click this option and I apply, then it has shown the tick levels here. These are the tick levels, and now they are here but without any line and text. And I can click from here, use the same option for this as well, and then they are shown over here as well. Similarly, if I want to have them on this axis as well, so I click here, same option, and I go to tick levels and same options, and now they are here as well. So it is up to us to decide about this. Normally in such a single binary data, we don't need this one. We don't need this one as well, and I apply. So title, so don't use those options here, and also not to show here. And here this one is short line and text, so I have just removed them. Show line and text, and now line and text are gone. For this axis, similarly this one I will show here, and they are gone. And now I will have to remove this one. So now we have we will have to show line and text. They are to be removed here. Both of these are to be removed, and now our text and they are no more. Here I will have to remove this one show, so this one is gone, and I will have to remove this one as well, show option, so they are gone. Normally in a binary data we are having axes like this. Okay, we can have inside the grids, like major grids, and these we can. So it will have some lines here and here. Let's say for example I say show and I apply, so it has shown me the vertical grid lines. Similarly we can have some minor as well, and it will show the minor as well. We can do the horizontal, so it will be the horizontal as well with the minor and major. So if these are required, we can do this one as well. If not required, we can remove them. Normally we don't want to have them. So this is a very simple plot, and we are having our plot like this. Now for example, let me press let me go here, and if I want to change these one, then I will go to the tick levels, and inside the tick levels, which are 1, 2, 3 here, I go to format. And inside a format, let's say for example I want to change their size, And from here I change their size to, let's say, a big number here, 24, and I apply. So they have been changed. If I want to make them bold, then I will have to select bold here. Similarly, on the vertical axis, this one, I can say over here 24 as well, and the bold, so they are like this. Similarly, if I want to make this wavelength bold, intensity means you increase the size and all this, then to the tick level, and I can change this one as well. Like I go to the title, and now inside the title, this is just taken from the worksheet, percent, and then Y, it means it's the Y axis. Similarly, I can change its color, its rotation, and its size from here. Let's say I give it 36 and I apply. So it has increased this one. I can change it for the x-axis as well, and let's say it is 36, and I have changed this one as well. If I want to change to go to other options, like I can do it another way as well, I select this one and then I just press Control Shift and the less symbol, so it will reduce them, do the greater R, the smaller symbol, and it will do the job. Similarly, here as well, if I select Control Shift, greater symbol will increase the size and smaller symbol will reduce the size. So these things I can do directly from the keypad as well, and from the menu there as well, I can do these changes directly. So here, this is the plot, a very simple plot, and to our data file, this is the data file, and now we are having the plot here.